bigger Amoeba Staff, and then the one that's on this one here. It's also a big Amoeba sound, so yeah, it's just like... I just like message. Or, I don't know if that will work. Another thing about this artist is he does this weird thing where he releases an album for 90 days and then deletes it or something, so you can't like buy it anymore. But because it's the internet, people just pirate the, like, just put up on like pirate websites. It gets popular enough that there's someone always posting it up on iTracker, I think. And it's just like, well, he's just no longer getting any money. It is. Well, I think like it works in terms of like people are like, oh, this is not going to be available in X amount of time, and I'm going to buy the album. It kind of like forces people to purchase it quickly, but on the same hand, people like me who aren't impulsive and aren't skewed by like marketing gimmicks like that, I feel like sour like buying it next time, even if I like the album, especially with my cash flow as well. Just like, it's like one of those sort of manipulative sort of marketing gimmicks that you pay corporate media for, and then just something the artist tells it. I can't remember what he, I think he referred to his first album as an undead album. I can't remember.
Thank you.
Yo, it's weird, I kept submitting, but because it generated the Greek character, like it started switching, but every time I finished writing the message out, it fired. Seen. Yeah, they're all self-published stuff, I think, because His record labels, a big amoeba sound, and then here's an album by another, his other name, called Amoeba EP. So it's just self-published. There's like zero reason why I just like forgot about it. You're alive? That's not as alive. Playing epically. Nope. too bad. I can't read the UI, but it looks pretty good because it's such a highly complicated the video. FPS is notorious for being hard to encode, but like side scrolling, like panning, our games is good. And I still can't hear you on the video. Are you not going to turn it on? Is that what you're saying? Wow, have you killed all of those zombies? I guess like when there's a lot of them around, maybe it's fine. I don't know how you did it, though. Risk business. Oh, shit. So we come out of like nowhere, basically. Where was he? Did he like come in through the door when you weren't looking or something? Cause that was weird. There's not many places he could have come from. Then you got a rope over the door. Oh, here. Over the door, over the window. I guess there's a window above. I need to go out. What annoys me about Project Dawnblade is I'm pretty sure they're doing something fucky with the graphics that they really don't need to. Like the lighting system in it looks like it updates way too slowly or something. And it's like, because they're doing this weird like hybrid 2D-3D thing when they could actually do the whole thing in 3D and get full real-time lighting. And they could have spent more time like doing like content. This 3D lighting is. The grass does fuck up the encoder a little. Holy shit, I'm watching that brawl on stream. I don't know how you like. Get out of that. That's a good idea, like, have them all on one side of you so you don't sneak up on you, but for a second there, they're surrounding you. Are you just using your hands? Like, it says you got a weapon. That's one of the stances look like you got a weapon, and then they just push. The knives and baseball bat for you. Twitch stream watches. That's the point door.
Blah.
Yeah. Huh. I'm a survivor.
Jesus, you done well. Oh god. No sheriff. Oh, I just had a thought. I'm gonna test something. talking about that.
It'd be nice if I could just like on Spotify, just like play all song, all albums from an artist, and on random. But
I don't even know.
What is that? I hear an echo. Signal on times across the street.
Should be better now. Better now. 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 I have buried you, Wobby. Yeah. Fucking time. You, Oh, yeah. Some of these trees that are growing in our place. Oh, nice.
Oh, by the way, you know how you use that Google DNS to 8, is it 8.8.8?
Yep.
Do you know about 1.1.1.1?
No, I knew about 8.8.8.4, or 8.8.4.4.
I'll send you a link to this one. So there's actually information on the website. Basically, that because it's like 1.1.1, it has some unique properties that like people coded in, like for years they've coded in like manual numbers, like 1.1.1 as an example, and it was so anyone who got the number ended up getting DDoSed or hit with like random traffic. So the company that got the number,
yeah,
they said okay, we'll have it for free under the condition that do some analytics on the kind of traffic that we're getting from it, and and we'll use it for our thing. I don't know if they needed to stipulate to have it for free, but yeah, and there's also a cryptid DNS version, but I could never like get it to reliably work. So. I'm actually really surprised it's like the one thing they haven't done is encrypt DNS. And this new product called DNS over HTTPS, which is really fun. DNS is like a really simple, lightweight protocol, and you can put it over this heavyweight HTTPS initiation. Which is probably why I had reliability issues. My DNS server does not need to have a HTTP stack. Good. There's a separate number for the DNS crypt. I can message them or find any contact download the Android app suggestions and that, but I think that's for the Android app. Hidden service as well. They've like, see, they've added some like meme. It's literally you can request DNS over by sending a text message. Like they've actually implemented that. They haven't implemented like DNS crypt, which is actually useful. Yeah, DNS over Google Sheets, DNS over SMS, DNS over Telegram, which is the app, I think, not an actual Telegram. DNS over Tor, Twitter, and email.
What do I want from this? I want two. Got a hammer and nails. Oh, I need to check the magazines, don't I?
Maybe they're actually trying to do DNS script, but they're actually... Because the other ones are memes, they didn't pay attention to the quality of the code, I don't know. Maybe that's what they're doing. Maybe it's actually a quality problem. Thank you. my Twitch, like, Twitch is a weird thing when you get like notifications for random shit. But that problem where you're like, follow and subscribe, and then it starts sending you emails.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to like unsubscribe on a per person basis or something. And then recently I subscribed to someone who does reruns, and then apparently started sending me emails again for reruns. Only reruns, nothing else. Yeah. So I have a feeling Project Dawn Void started out as a 2D game, did it? Like, yeah. Because the play models are now 3D. The car's definitely 3D because those things rotate perfectly.
Yeah. Have you seen the
Yeah, the animation stuff.
Yeah, looks pretty good.
Yeah, I think they actually need to like, they need to ditch. Well, I guess the thing is it's slow and steady kind of thing they're doing, but they seem to be like their development time is really slow. I don't know why. Is it game from like, isn't it like 5 or 6 years old or something? It still feels like it's in like alpha, like not unstable, but it's like there's still lots of like details that have been added that you'd expect in a finished game, like animations. It's a lot of content, it's just that not the content has been padded with animations. Yeah.
I didn't hear the gunshots at all, which is interesting.
Did you? Oh, you didn't tell Phoenix about how what happened when you spawned?
Yeah, he did.
Oh, shit. He did.
Just straight away zombies.
When did this game come out? There's no release date on Theft of 2 laptops containing code prompt on board. God damn it. I think I vaguely remember this incident. I didn't remember what project it was, but like, holy shit, you have commercial code on 2 laptops and that's it. Like, your entire business model is reliant on 2 laptops. I think I remember like, that's really interesting how people prefer Google Checkout over PayPal. Check demo was 2011. It was written in Java for its portability. Wow, that's a bit of a meme.
Yep.
You can write portable C code, like. Pretty sure like the idea of portable Java, portable code, write once, run anywhere, died in like 2011. It's a bit interesting. I can see, like, why Minecraft and Project Zomboid didn't take the best route. A lot of people, like, both games took years to get, like, out of beta, basically. And there are other games, like, especially the ones built on, like, Unreal or, Unity. Got out a lot quicker and have like actual content because that's all we have to focus. It's a bit of a toss up if you want like a well optimized engine for your specific use case. Not to say that Project Zomboid is that well, but Minecraft definitely is. Apparently Microsoft re-implemented Minecraft in C++ as well, like after they brought the game. But after that, of course, you get a big man team, and they all like, once you've figured out what the game, how the game's supposed to be structured, rewriting a code is so much easier. Because it's the development process of Minecraft that was part of that thing, but Minecraft still looks retarded with all its animation. Like every item has the same exact animation when you use it. Opening a door, swipe. You like engineer the kit so that all the animations all the animations are the same, but like for example, if you're opening a door, you have to use a swipe card because it's a slash down. And there's no other way to like make it look natural. It's an engineering a game like that. Your art direction follows the animation limitations as opposed to the other way around. What are space engineers in Unreal? I have a feeling it's Unreal. I'll be wrong there. Space Engines uses an in-house built V-Rage 2.0 realistic volumetric based physics engine, but it says physics engine, which means they could have tacked it on to any graphics thingy. The graphics engine or physics engine aren't actual. Oh no, there's actually a game engine according to Wikipedia. The Space Engineers isn't even their first game. Minor Wars 2081. Wait, oh, 2000. Oh shit, the source code is available for Mine Wars as well.
That one's finished reading. Damn, this is gonna be a good one. Let's see what that looks like. Christian stir-fry. It's got butter, tomato, potato, cabbage, carrot, and salt.
Yeah, they made the game engine look so much better though, the V-Rage, like... I think it's... Is it AO? They've got like some correction on the lighting that's making it look so much better. It must have been an update at some point, because...
What's that for?
Space Engineers.
Yeah.
Like... It had that really like... Originally it had that really 90s look to it, like that sort of... Like everything is feng shading.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's not really 90s, though. That's like mid-2000s, isn't it?
I guess so.
Because feng shading only became a thing with what? Actually, late 2000s. I'm thinking of Lost Coast.
Like, this is sort of... Actually, looking at, like... Looking at the old screenshot, it just looks flat. Like, there's no... Oh yeah, there's a bit of fong shading on the visor there. Clearly fong, but... But the, I don't know if they did later. I think it might be some post-processing, and maybe they did color correction. Correction of some sort.
Yeah.
Oh yes, because the metal in that has like reflections as well. The new lens flares. IO on the face. I don't know, just be baked. It's a bit of bloom everywhere, like they've really. I don't know if that's even just post-processing on the face. I know, noticed that in a few games with like screenshots and the hard shadows would definitely suit the like in the older screenshots the shadows were like there's actually not a lot of shadows in the other one, that's probably half the issue. I have a feeling these guys are like real good. They have a real solid, like, technical competence. Which is why they have this awesome, like, physics engine for the ship and stuff. And why the art's a bit generic looking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that your biggest thing about if you want to start a game, like, and try to commit to it? You know, it's like going to be a 14-year project. It's like, do I really want to do that? And the majority of projects fails. Sick of looking for a job. But I'm also sick of not having money, so it's like commit to like a project, like making a game. muted someone asking me a question, and I was like, why did one of me just answer? Yeah. And I was another chick that didn't message you, because I was like, what? I didn't message you.
Turns out he's Gotti all along. Yeah.
You know what's funny?
Life.
Actually, I've been drinking like water with a hint of cider vinegar in it.
Yep.
And like, I've also got some sports water there. It's like kind of sweet with lots of it's an isotonic formula.
Yep.
Put that in there as well, but it's like better than like just drinking fizzy all the time. I'm probably sure, pretty sure that the side of vinegar is ruining my teeth, just like Coke would.
Yep.
It's really bad. It doesn't leave that fur on your teeth like Coke does. It's nice.
That's time 11. 1:46.
Yo. It's okay. I'm looking at like game dev stuff because I'd say the appeal of using a pre-built engine, but at the same time, it's like... like... yeah. The Oryx portal game engine. Modular game engine, like, glue things together. And then you can, like, be a bit more flexible on how you glue them together. Wait, is there a new Borderlands coming out?
Probably.
Apparently there was a tech demo in Unreal 4 in 2017.
Yeah, they were doing, like, some shadow, like, shadow casting things. I remember that one.
Borderlands 3 tech demo.
It wasn't explicitly Borderlands, it was using a very similar art style, but the guy kept saying, no, this isn't Borderlands, it's just a tech demo.
Jesus, that grass fucks with the encoder, man. Yeah. Apparently there's the tab open, so it's still there. Still better locking than most of the part than the first business bar.
What happened?
I just saw that. Yeah, I just saw that. Oh, yeah, it's the other one. Oh, that's hilarious. Oh, and he got up as well. That's it. He just like climbs out the window and he doesn't give two shits about the height it is, so.
If you were dead, would you care?
That's actually the best reasoning, right? Like, that's why we have zombie games, man. It's because the AI has to be dumb. Like, the AI can be dumb, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, look. That's like on Payday, too. They're basically zombies.
They tend to take some cover.
Yeah, but it's like scripted. It's like, you know, basic scripting. It's not like,
yeah.
They do it kind of retarded sometimes. They actually kind of Paddy, who reminds me of the soldiers from Half-Life 1.
Yeah, agreed.
Don't know why exactly, but they're. Maybe it's because they're similar sort of brutal aim and damage output, but like kind of real boring movement.
And yet, for a lot of people,
chatter,
like,
and radio chatter.
When they first, yeah, when they first came out in Half-Life 1, people were like, "Oh my god, this is incredible!" I have to actually like think about how I approach this, and yeah. And they're talking to me. Circle around back. You are nothing.
Well, that's weird. I just realized Messenger just lists shared files in a section on desktop. Apparently, I activated my Facebook at some point. Can't be bothered to say deactivating it, and I like going to use Messenger in the browser, so. Just won't load it up.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Something. This one isn't like clearing the message. Why not read message? Do I have to click the link? It doesn't fix it either. Mark is reading.
I just had to harvest all of the veg up because some of it was actually rotting in the ground. And it was all getting parched. It looks like we're actually in the summer period now. That means we're not likely to see rain for a while. Go to the lake. Have you got a watch by any chance? Did you notice that it got up to like 80 degrees Fahrenheit? Like I say, I think it's... Yeah, it's come down to 75 Fahrenheit. How do you set it to Celsius? Because I'd prefer that myself. Display, perhaps. There we go. Celsius. Here. That's an oddity. Dynamic skybox. When the hell do you see a skybox? Oh, reflection in the car windows. Yeah. That'll be it though, right? Probably. Oh, that makes it easier. I changed the colour of highlighted items. makes it way easier to tell. I've changed it from, like, orange to a bright green. It's like, yep, you've got this one selected. Okay, cool. Way better. It's in the same menu, gameplay menu. It's an interesting trait to take. I will tell you how many cigarettes we currently have. 79. At least in that specific area anyway. Check all of them. Cigars. cigarette. Cigarette. The crew regulated smoking cigarro.
Thank you. Ugh.
Oh, damn. It's foggy too, is it? God damn, it really is just like... Okay, we got rid of that guy. Here's another two. Got rid of those two. So what would happen if... Yeah, I'm watching the stream. What would happen if you just got out of the site? Did they still find you? I think with a lighter game like this, you could probably stand to throw the quality of the stream up just a little bit. Because, yeah, I can't read any of the text in the dialogue boxes at all. Level up. And the fog's finally lifting too. So how many have you managed to kill now? Wow. That's more than I think I've ever killed in the game. I think the word is teeming. It's teeming with zombies. Yeah. Ambulance. Amber lamps. Whoa, Black Betty. Amber lamps.
Jesus, all the zombies.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sweet. I just watched one of the more recent episodes of Punisher. It's been really interesting. It's been probably less fight focused, but yeah, it's nowhere near uninteresting, which is good. Ah, yeah, you have changed your color, I see. Yeah, the green definitely stands out. That way you really understand which one you're actually looking at. Like how there's a zombie just standing out there. I come in! Burb. For some reason, I'm reminded of the Simpsons, where Homer and Marge go and get Marge's mother, and Grandpa goes, "Oh, I'll be back in a jiffy." Comes back out with some random woman with kind of high up hair as well. It's not my mother. I'll be back in a jiffy. Runs off. Can I come too? And just rolls the window up. There it is. Actually, it's amazing. I just realized in that clip, Homer winds up the window from the other side of the car, but you can see the actual winder on the door. Wonder if that's in the goose section. I bet it is. That, I wonder. Lady Boogie is lava, that's it. I had quit out for the intervening time while I was watching the video. Didn't want to starve while I was watching TV. Don't know. Basically, he's got he was here, but he's obviously gone AFK. Hang on. Hello.
Hello.
Oh, there we go. I wasn't quite expecting that to work.
I
figured since you do that to one of me, I'd do it to you.
Yeah, it worked. Alright, I was just doing other shit, so... Are you guys still playing Project Zomboid? I'm keen to see if I can get Apex to crash.
Oh,
it's like when you wear out something, right? Like, that's W-E-A-R, right? Not W-A-R-E.
Yes. No. A-R-E only refers to goods.
Alright. I'm making a comment. Someone's like talking about how poorly, how well maintained our roads are in New Zealand.
Yeah.
To some other places. And someone said, it's like, the chip seal sucks and blah, blah, blah. Sometimes the asphalt's better, and I was like, I'm pretty sure I've seen asphalt in specifically high weird locations.
Yeah, that'd be W-E-A-R, high wear.
I just saw something.